Good evening, dear colleagues. First of all, I would like to thank you, to thank organizers for the opportunity to take a speech on this interesting conference. I represent Pacific Institute of Bioorganic Chemistry, Vladivostok, Laboratory of Peptide Chemistry. Unfortunately, no, the director of our institute, Valentina Ronchestonik, no, the head of my laboratory, Paulina Kozlovskaya, couldn't participate, but they asked me to make some reminiscence remarks about our long and fruitful collaboration between our institutes, and to make a report devoted to some recent investigation of our laboratory, which were partially initiated by the outstanding scientist, great organizer and very good kind person, Eugene Grisham. About 40 years ago, by the decision of Yuri Ovchinnikov, Pacific Institute of Bioorganic Chemistry was included to the program NEOF Impulse. It is known that sea organisms are a rich source of different, diverse biological active compounds. As a result of some expeditions to the sea of Atlantic, Indian and Pacific Oceans, the most interesting sources were selected, and among them were sea anemones. as a result, five new neurotoxins of two type neurotoxins were isolated in our institute, characterized, but the mechanisms were determined in the laboratory of Grisham in Moscow and in Kiev in Bogomolets Institute of Physiology. The fundamental data were obtained at the time. The next impulse in our laboratory, another impulse for new experiments were made in 2006 due to investigation. Invitation of our laboratory in 2006 by Evgeny Grishin into federal grant by the searching of analgesic compounds among marine sources. the last visit of Eugene Grishin to Vladivostok was in 2011 during Asian IST meeting. You also have seen the photo and boom. we hope that all that all projects of Eugene Grisham will continue successfully due to his sense to his clever and talented followers. We also want to thank all collaborators of Eugene Grisham for help on separate steps of our investigation. And we also hope that connection between our institutes will keep. So, the next I would like to tell some recent investigation of biological activities of recent investigation of different type peptides. Due to particular interest to these molecules, because their interest and fold, activities, polyfunctionality, and diversity. it is well known that agonistic peptides, besides inhibition of proteases, could block or modulate potassium channels or TRPV1 receptor. Besides, they can possess analgesic, anti-inflammation, anti-histaminative uses, and our recent investigation can I tell about neuroprotective activity of such molecules. we have found that CNM inhibitor ActyS3 produce an abundant agonistic peptides which are encoded by multigene superfamily consists of some subfamilies. RCGS, RG, GG, EGN subfamilies named after dipeptide of these molecules. GS peptides is abundant, the most numerous group of the peptide, and according to the amino acids in the P1 position of the molecule, they are clusters into three groups. We obtained recombinant peptides from the each cluster with lysine in a P1 position, arginine and threonine. I should be noted that this so-called analgesic cluster and it composed peptides APRC1 and 2 and 3, which about Dr. Kozlov talking yesterday. And it is interesting that each peptide from each cluster show analgesic activity in experiment in vivo tail-flick model. Besides, these peptides show antihistamine activity, releasing calcium collection. And peptide HGS 1.20 show reduces the level of nitric azote in lipopolysaccharide induced macrophage. We assume that this development of such activities is related with the interaction of some Kunitz peptides with histamine receptors, or maybe with inflammation proteases. The new subfamily HCRG peptides consists of 32 representatives, and it is interesting that the most of them have lysine is in its reactive site and clustered with GS peptides. Besides, one unique molecule, HCGR21, which only one have P1 threonine and falls to the analgesic cluster. According to electrophysiological tests, we determined with the laboratory of Jan Tilgert that combined implication of RCRG21 with capsaicin significantly reduced current through TRP1 receptor at 95%. although HCRG21 is appear to have low affinity to this receptor than APHC1, it has higher efficacy, and we think that it's a full antagonist, that full first antagonist of the TRPV1 receptor peptide imaging. We try to determine the main difference, and we noticed that there are some differences in the, between ABHC and SCRG interactions with the extracellular site of TRP1. According to docking analysis, N-terminal peptide of RCRG21 make multiple hydrogen bonds electrostatic interaction with two subunits of receptor in the contrast to ABHC, which interact only with one subunit. Also, we saw that there's a pore size and different diameter of the pore, 5.39 for SCRG21 and 9.5 angstroms for ABHC1. We think it's good to relate with the electrophysiological data. Besides recombinant, we also obtained isolate native peptides of this family, RCRG1 and RCRG2, which show anti-inflammatory activity, lowering the concentration of inflammation mediators like pro-insulin interleukin alpha beta, tumor necrosis factor, and interleukin 6. It is the first notice that polystyrene peptides from CNN and you could have anti-inflammatory action. Besides this recent investigation, that we have shown that the pre-incubation of these two peptides, RCRG and RCRG2, with pre-incubation before the ending amyloid B, increase the survival of neurons cells in Alzheimer's disease experimental model. We saw that activity of RG1 higher than 2, and we now just can assume that it's connected maybe with prevention penetration of amyloid to the cell, and the action in such low concentration may be connected with the interaction with some receptor. It's our future in study. This is my acknowledgement to all who participate in this work. It's Russia, Belgium, and Taiwan work. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Irina, for the nice presentation. Maybe we still have time also for a couple of questions.
Right. My question is about the anti-inflammatory peptides. What is the reason for C. anemones to have these peptides in the first place?
It's a very interesting question. Because this object, it's interesting and difficult questions to say, because we just we have a puzzled picture to find what molecules on what touches it acts. Maybe someday we can make this picture.
No, I appreciate that, but it's interesting. Yes. But also neuroprotective peptides. Why should C. anemones have neuroprotective peptides? Sorry, I know it's impossible to answer. It's just a theoretical question only.
Maybe the last just I saw an article where I show that in Cyanemones, Cyanemones have channels like in human.
All right, that may be the reason.
Other questions or remarks, suggestions? Okay, if not, then thanks again. Dr. Dati, once more.